السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله النبي الكريم. أما بعد، الحمد لله الله سبحانه وتعالى has really blessed us. وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. If you were to count the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, we would never be able to count them. The fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed us to offer Salatul Isha with Jama'ah in the masjid is a blessing. The fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed us, and I'm choosing my words very carefully, allowed us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His infinite mercy allowed us and chose us. Out of the thousands of Muslims, not even around the world, the thousands of Muslims around Georgia, Allah selected the few of us to offer Salatul Jama'ah, Salatul Isha with Jama'ah. It is a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La in shakartum la azidannakum. Oh Allah, we thank you for giving us the strength, the ability, for allowing us to pray Isha in the masjid with congregation. Oh Allah, continuously allow us to pray with Jama'ah. It is a blessing. It is a blessing that, you know, we haven't fully understood. The second blessing is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the strength, the ability to sit in the masjid, listening to His kalam, listening to His words, listening to the teachings of our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What an honor. On a Friday night, we can be doing whatever we want. Day off, weekend is starting, I can do whatever I want. But I'm sitting here listening to the words of Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Allah's allowing me to hear this. Subhanallah, what a blessing. Oh Allah, continue these ears. Oh Allah, continue to allow these ears to hear your words and the words of your Habib, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The kuffar in the time of the Prophet of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would say, if you hear Muhammad talking, cover your ears. Don't listen to him. If you listen to him, he's gonna, you know, perform black magic on you. Don't listen to him. Cover your ears. Don't listen to him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowing us to hear his kalam and the teachings of our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is an immense blessing, a great blessing, an honorable blessing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to bless us. Now, alhamdulillah, I've had the privilege of, since I've graduated, I've been teaching every year. I graduated in about 2012. For about 10 years straight, I've been teaching. And our madrasa and our own institute opened in 2015, 2016. So I've been teaching at our own institute for the past 6 years. And inshallah, this year, we'll have our first graduates too, inshallah. Now, because we have more students, we have more staff, I'm able to go out a little bit more. And I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses me to serve this community. And you know, we say serve. Because as ulama, students, children, the fact we get to speak about deen is an honor that Allah is using us to serve it. It's not like we're doing something we're getting. No, Allah continue to use us to serve His deen. I always say to the students, to the staff, and to everyone I meet, ask Allah to use you for the service of His deen. Ask Allah, every dua you can make, oh Allah, use me for the service of your deen. There's a hadith in Mishkat al-Masabi, also found in Zad al-Talibin. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيُؤَيِّدَ هَذَا الدِّينَ بِرَجُلٍ فَاجِرٍ وَفِي رَوَايَةٍ بِرَجُلٍ كَافِرٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can strengthen this deen, give this deen power in quwwah, with بِرَجُلٍ فَاجِرٍ, with a transgressing Muslim, a man who is full of sins. وَفِي رَوَايَةٍ بِرَجُلٍ كَافِرٍ. Allah can preserve, strengthen, and protect this deen with a non-Muslim. Allah doesn't need us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Allah doesn't need us. So we ask Allah to use us for the service of His deen. Now, obviously, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you study the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has so many teachings, so many beautiful teachings. But I would say, to an extent, One of the most important blessings, one of the most important teachings of our Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the fact that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught the Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in adab. He taught them adab. He taught them manners. He taught them etiquettes. He taught them how to have conversations. He taught them how to eat. He taught us how to walk. He taught us how to do everything. Right? Some non-Muslims were making fun of and mocking the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at your Habib, look at your Prophet. Your Prophet even teaches you how to use the bathroom. They're mocking him. They're mocking the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Salman al-Farsi radiallahu ta'ala, he says, yeah, he does. He tells us what we can and cannot do. What's wrong with that? He's teaching us adab. He's teaching us how to clean ourselves. And if we don't have these guidelines, people don't know how to clean themselves after they relieve themselves. Adab is extremely important. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I have been sent to perfect character. Imam al-Bukhari rahimallah. He collected and compiled a hadith just on adab. Al-adab al-mufrad. Just on adab, just on etiquette. How to talk to each other. How should children talk to parents? How should parents talk to children? How should youngsters talk to elders? How should elders talk to youngsters? How we should treat the animal kind? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us adab. I tell my students, and I'm pretty sure you tell your children too. If your child does good, and the students do good in their grades, good, alhamdulillah. They got good grades. But if they got horrible grades, but they have excellent manners, it's worth it. But if they have good grades and horrible manners, you're not, I don't want you to be with me. Because the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spread this deen through adab. He spread this deen through respect. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one time he was sitting with our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Somebody came and said, Assalamu alaikum, Assalamu alaikum. Assam in Arabic means poison. In other words, it's metaphorically saying, may you be destroyed. Assalamu alaikum, may you be destroyed. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she was there. So she said, and the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he responded to them with wa alaikum. They said, Assalamu alaikum. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, wa alaikum. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, wa alaikum wa la'anahu Allah wa ghadabu Allahu alayhi. She said, wa alaikum, may you be destroyed, may the curse of Allah be upon you, may Allah be angered with you. Ya Aisha, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looks at his wife Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, mahlan ya Aisha, alayki bir rifki. Aisha, calm down. Relax. Alayki bir rifki. Be soft. Be kind. Be nice, be forgiving. Ya Rasulullah, did you not hear what they said? Did you not hear what they said? Ya Aisha, awalam tasma'i, did you hear what I said? Did you hear what I said? I said, wa alaikum. Okay. They said, assalamu alaikum, destruction be to you. So I said, wa alaikum, and to you. That's it. Nothing more. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, one time, Ra'is al-Munafiqeen Abdullah ibn Ubay, he sent one of his khadams to go fill up my bucket with water. Go fill up my bucket with water. So, the khadam of Abdullah ibn Ubay came back late. Fa'abta'a. He came back late. So Abdullah ibn Ubay, Ra'is al-Munafiqeen, he's a leader of the hypocrites. He asked his khadam, what took you so long? I've been waiting for you. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he responded, he said, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he was standing by the well. And he wasn't letting anyone get water out of the well until mala'a kirab al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa mala'a kirabi Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And he wasn't letting anyone get water from the well until the bucket or, you know, the cup or the jug was filled with water for the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and for Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. Then he let everyone else get water. So Abdullah ibn Ubay, he cursed at the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He cursed at Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Somebody came and told Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala that Abdullah ibn Ubay said this. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala yuridu bis-sayf. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, he intended to grab his sword. He intended to grab his sword. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Umar, ala rislik, relax, don't worry. Ya Rasulullah, did you not hear what Abdullah ibn Ubay said? Oh Umar, we are told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Jasiyah, Kulil ladina amanu yakfiru. Oh Muhammad, tell the believers to forgive, to overlook, to pardon. Don't worry about it, let it go. This is adab. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam spread this deen throughout the world, the four corners of the world, not through the sword, but through his adab, through his respect, through his manners, through his etiquettes. When the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would talk to someone, the companions say, every one of us felt that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam considered us to be his best friend. Everyone would say, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala, he said, Ya Rasulullah, who's your favorite? Who do you love the most? Who do you love the most, Ya Rasulullah? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Aisha. Subhanallah. We're told to not express love. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asked, who do you love the most? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without hesitation, says, I love my wife, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha the most. No, min al-rijal. From the men, who do you love the most? Abuha. I love her father the most, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. Okay, thumma man, then who? Then the Prophet said, name, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala. He says, you know, I'm not going to ask anymore, because I'm scared he's not going to say my name. But before I asked him, I thought he was going to say my name. Because that's how he treated me. He made everyone feel like you were their best friend. إِذَا أَكْبَلَ أَكْبَلَ جَمِيعًا وَإِذَا أَدْبَرَ أَدْبَرَ جَمِيعًا. When you look at someone, look at them with your full body. Don't turn your body to the side and then look at face towards that person, but your body to the right. No. إِذَا أَقْبَلَ أَقْبَلَ جَمِيعًا. Prophet of Allah said, when you look at someone, you're talking to someone, fully look at that person. Adab is, you look at that person attentively. Not on your phone, not texting, but you look at that person. وَإِذَا أَدْبَرَ أَدْبَرَ جَمِيعًا. When you turn around completely. But if you're talking to someone, give them full attention. These are adab. These are respect. These are the etiquettes taught by our Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the subject of learning manners, these small actions could change the world. These small actions could change the world. These small actions could lead to someone becoming a Muslim. There was an imam in London. And you know, he got on the bus. And, you know, when he came on the bus, he gave the bus driver the money. And the bus driver gave him about 25 pence, or we can say 25 cents in America. 25 pence, or 25 cents extra. So the imam had that 25 cents in his pocket the whole time. He's thinking, man, it's only 25 cents. Should I tell him he gave me extra? Is it a big deal? It's not that big of a deal. Should I keep it? The whole ride, he's thinking, should I keep it? Should I tell him? Should I not tell him? What should I do? So he said, finally, my stop came. So I went to the front, I was about to get off. And I turned around and I said to the driver, you gave me a little extra, I wanted to give it back to you. The driver looked at him and he smiled. He said, I did it on purpose. You look like a Muslim. And I heard a lot of good things about Muslims. And I heard Muslims have the best of manners and they have very good etiquette. So I tested you. I gave you 25 cents extra to see would you give it back to me or not. Because I know everyone on this bus wouldn't give it back to me. But if I heard about you guys are really good people. And I wanted to test it. I wanted to see if you would give it back to me. And he said, I want to let you know. Can you please tell me the masjid that you go to? Because I would like to become a Muslim. He got off the bus. The imam said, my legs were shaking. He said, I almost sold my deen for 25 cents. I almost sold my deen for 25 cents. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best gift a father can give a child is good manners. Not good education, not a lot of money, not leave behind a lot of wealth. Good manners. Akhlaq, respect. Adab, how do you treat your elders? How do you talk to your parents? If your elders are wrong, how do you address them? In a respectful manner. You don't walk in front of them. You don't talk above them. You don't talk louder than them. You're not rude to them. Right? The Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he says to make dua for the parents, what did he say? وَقْفِدْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحًا مِنَ الظُّلِ. You know, put yourself down and then make dua for them. Humble yourself, humiliate yourselves in front of your elders and your parents. These are the adab that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. But he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't just tell us, didn't just tell the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, he taught them. I'll give you an example. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he lost his father, he lost his parents. So he's never to an extent able to show us how to respect parents. He wasn't able to show us physically. He would tell us, but he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam couldn't really show it to us. There was an uncle of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by the name of Abu Lahab. He became called Abu Lahab. And Abu Lahab would cause a lot of difficulty, you know, calamity and problems to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So one day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told, وَأَنزِرْ عَشِيرَتِكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ. You know, go warn your family members and go tell them about Islam. So the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called everyone to the Mount Safa. He gathered everyone there. Abu Lahab was there. His family members were there. His cousins were there. His uncles were there. Everyone was there. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't you guys trust me? Of course we trust you. أَنْتَ الْأَمِينَ. You're al-Amin. You're the trustworthy. So if I were to tell you that there's an army behind this mountain, would you believe me? Of course we would believe you. Okay. So I want to warn you about something far worse. And that is azabun shadeed. That is about a severe punishment that will come in the hereafter if you don't believe in the oneness of Allah. And the Prophet of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was calling his family members towards the oneness of Allah. Abu Lahab says, tabbalaka ya Muhammad. Ali hadha jama'tana? Tabbalaka ya Muhammad. Destruction be to you, Muhammad. Is this why you have gathered us? For this nonsense? Oh my nephew, is this why you have gathered us? Abu Lahab is the uncle of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Lahab, on the birth of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Lahab was so happy, he freed one of his slaves out of happiness. Oh Muhammad, he's your uncle, you don't respond. You don't respond, you show adab. You show respect. Oh Muhammad, you don't respond. Muhammad, I'll respond for you. Near the end of the Quran, what do we have? Qul, ya ayyuhal kafirun. Muhammad, say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qul, huwa Allahu ahad. Qul, a'udhu bi rabbil falak. Qul, a'udhu bi rabbil nas. But does it say, Qul, tabbat yada abi lahabi wa tab? Oh Muhammad, you don't say it, I'll say it for you. He's your uncle, so respect. He's a mushrik. He doesn't believe in Allah. No, you show adab. You show respect. You show respect. Asma binti Abi Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala came to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, ya Rasulullah, my mother, wa hiya mushrika. She's araghibun ali. She's always, you know, inclined to me. She wants me to be with her. She wants me to spend time with her. But she's a non-Muslim. She's not a believer. What should I do, ya Rasulullah? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Asma radiallahu ta'ala, sili. And you go take care of your mother. She's your mother. Doesn't matter if she's Muslim or not. She's your mother. Go take care of her. When Fir'aun, and I end this, and with this inshallah. When Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa salam was told to go back to Fir'aun. اِذْهَبَا إِلَى فِرْعَوْنَ فَإِنَّهُ تَغَى. O Musa and Harun alayhi salatu wa salam, go to Fir'aun for he has rebelled. He has transgressed the boundaries and the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when he was sent there, now, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam grew up in the kingdom of Fir'aun. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam's upbringing was done in the kingdom of Fir'aun. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to Fir'aun, what did he say? O Musa, go to him. فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. O Musa, when you talk to Fir'aun, talk to him in a kind manner, in a respectful manner, in a soft manner. Don't be rude. You grew up in his kingdom. He has a favor upon you. Don't be rude to them. Who's Fir'aun? Fir'aun used to say, Ana Rabbuk. Fir'aun used to say, I'm your Lord. Fir'aun used to say, I can bring the dead back, and I can execute people. I'm your Lord. He used to tell everyone to worship him. Fir'aun, you can say, after Shaitan, is the worst creation of Allah. But even then, what is Musa alayhi salatu wasalam told? Go be harsh, go be rude. Shirk in the shirk al-adhim al-azim. Shirk is the worst type of sin. Shirk is the sin Allah won't forgive. He's not even associating partners with Allah. He's saying, I am Allah. But even then, Musa is told what? قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا فَقُولًا لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. Talk to him softly. Be kind. Be respectful. So adab is from amongst, you can say, The most important thing in Islam is adab. The Prophet of Allah spread this deen through adab, through respect. When he moved to Medina, he made Aws and Khazraj like best friends. Aws and Khazraj were enemies to each other. Aws and Khazraj were enemies to each other. But as soon as they believed in Islam, they said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. We're believers now. The Prophet of Allah said, لَا تَبَاغَدُوا وَلَا تَحَاسَدُوا وَلَا تَدَابَرُوا وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا. O believers, don't hate each other, don't be jealous of each other, don't turn your backs off each other, and become brothers. O slaves of Allah, become brothers. وَلَا يَحِلَّ لِمُسْلِمًا أَن يَحْجَرَ أَخَاهُ فَوْكَ ثَلَاثِ لَيَالٍ. It is not permissible for a Muslim to be upset with his brother for more than 3 days. For more than 3 days, it's not allowed. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. We're all family. You're Muslim, you're my brother. You're Muslim, you're part of my family. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. If you understood Arabic, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word إِخْوَةٌ. إِخْوَةٌ is a deeper meaning of brotherhood. إِخْوَةٌ is a deeper meaning of brotherhood. So, how we would treat our brothers with respect, how we treat our elders, etc. Inshallah, we will be using this book called Islamic Manners. Originally, it is written in Arabic. It is called Min Adab al-Islam. It is called Min Adab al-Islam. It is written by Shaykh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghuddah Rahmatullahi Alayh. Abdul Fattah Abu Ghuddah Rahmatullahi Alayh is a very famous Syrian scholar, and he's one of those scholars that was respected by both the Arab world and the Indian subcontinent. Both of them respected him, you know, admired him. We study his books, we study his students' books, we, you know, read his books. So he wrote a book called Min Adab al-Islam, telling Muslims in Syria at that time how to be proper Muslims. And I think we'll try to make it relevant to this time. A lot of the things that he mentioned can be relevant to this time. This is the translation, and I think it's a very good translation too. You'll find a lot of PDFs and different translations too. But this copy right here is an excellent translation, I would say. And I did share the link. So inshallah, not next week, but the week after, I think we're trying to do this bi-weekly, or whenever we schedule the next one, inshallah, we're going to do it based off of this book, either one chapter or two chapter. And this should be very important for the entire family. For the children, adults, youngsters, everyone, it'll be beneficial. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the tawfiq, to give us the divine ability to act upon it. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the divine ability to act upon it and bring adab in our life. And through adab, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite all of us. Jazakum Allahu khayran wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.